charged jack spring, powers by inches at the start finish line. Talk about a photo finish.
What is a moment?
Martin tries to go up to speed. He gets pushed. Martin spins down on the infield grass. McCovey blocks him and contact is made. The top two wreck on the front stretch.
A line of events pieced together, capturing people, places, and objects in one instant.
Bodine looks high. Crawford's going to follow him.
He spins a big contact.
It's in the books. Checkered flag. Johnny Benson wins.
Spanning 10 months, moments have connected from one to another, creating solid lines, defining careers.
And he's spinning on the racetrack. The nine is around.
It took a spin and win move. Travis Quappel wins.
Bodine pinned to the bottom of the racetrack. Crawford right there. Benson is right there.
Two drivers, equally classified as champions, have weathered unfortunate events and turned catastrophe into valuable lessons of responsibility.
Let's see how these next 2 miles change the complexion of the points battle.
This could be the race that could decide who wins the title.
Oh, no. Ron, what are they?
Points leader.
Absolutely demoralizing this is for Mike Skinner. He's been black flagged.
Eagles have the lead. Hornaday and Skinner slide as they go through 3 and 4.
And, of course, success follows those who dedicate themselves to the optimal goal at hand.
Ron Hornaday will win.
Hornaday gets the victory.
Checkered flag in the air. Mike Skinner wins.
Skinner is going to win.
So, it's come to this. One final moment to assemble. Tonight, the most important milestone is at hand. The crowning of a new Truck Series champion. The precise instant where everything aligns. Because in a moment, everything is right where it belongs.
Truck Series Ford 200, Homestead Miami Speedway in Homestead, Florida. Gorgeous evening for racing. It's down to two drivers battling for a championship. Will it be Mike Skinner, our leader coming into this race, or Ron Hornaday? Let's go back trackside for tonight's command.
Are you ready? The time is now. It's time for the most famous words in motorsports. Please welcome Ford Truck Group Marketing Manager, Mike Crowley, to give the command.
Gentlemen, start your engines!
Between us and the green flag here for the final race of the 2007 season. Welcome back here on Speed. It's the Ford 200 from Homestead Miami Speedway, the final race of the 2007 season. 62 degrees at the start of this race. Clear skies. We saw shots of the moon earlier. Under the lights, once again, on this mile-and-a-half track to determine our champion. We want to take a look at the Ford point standings through the 24 races that we have labored through at times. Mike Skinner and Ron Hornaday now just 29 points separate the two of them to determine our champion. Anybody on this list can move and change positions. Guys like Travis Quappel, he can't move up, but he could definitely move back in this race. How will they line up? That starting grid is going to roll across the bottom of your screen. John Wood setting a new track record earlier today in qualifying. He and Johnny Benson make up row number one. That will continue to roll across the bottom of the screen. We take a look at our Priceline track description, Phil.
What a great racetrack. A mile and a half in length. You see the corners are progressively banked. 18 degrees at the bottom, up to 20 degrees at the top. The straightaway is only 4 degrees. Speeds upwards of 180 miles an hour on the straightaways here. You see concentric straightaways, 1,760 feet each.
Mikey, what about our MSD race analysis?
This race is going to have so many twists and turns that this page can't tell the story, but MSD Ignitions is going to tell us that the race is 201 miles, 134 laps. They're racing for just over $650,000. The pit window is somewhere between 60 and 65 laps, Phil, but you can see that's dangerously close to half this race can be ran on one tank of gas, and you could pit. What about the strategies that these guys are going to play out today?
Yeah, I don't think they can make it halfway, though. I think it's going to be just shy of that.
A lot of strategies going to take place. I talked about it during the Ford point standings. A lot of positions could be made up or lost today. We're going to take a look at 6th through 3rd in our speed spotlight today. And starting in the 6th position in the points is Rick Crawford. Adam Alexander, tell us a little bit more about him.
And Rick Crawford starts 23rd tonight in the race. He dropped to 6th last week after a 12th place finish at Phoenix. He's only 9 points behind Johnny Benson for a spot in the top 5, but he can still get 3rd, only 53 points out of the 3rd position for Rick Crawford. He's looking to make his way toward the front in the final race here tonight. Ray?
You know, Adam, last week at Phoenix, obviously everybody said it was highly controversial that Johnny Benson passed his teammate Mike Skinner. But guess what? Johnny's trying to race for his sponsors, for Exide and all the folks on board, and he's trying to get his best position that he can in the points. Believe it or not, he could go all the way to 3rd tonight. He's just 45 points behind Travis Quaffle. So Benson hoping to win the race tonight and hoping not to cause a championship for Mike Skinner. Phil?
Ray, I want to talk about our defending champion right there, that 30 Lumber Liquidators Toyota Tabodine. What a great season he had. 2006, won that championship. He's only 7 points out of 3rd position. Would love to get 3rd in this championship battle. Knows he can't get 1st or 2nd. 2 wins already this season. Would love to make it 3. And he will start this race from the 4th position. Mikey.
Racers watch speed, Phil. I love speed because I'm a racer. And if you're a racer, you want to finish 3rd in the points. You don't want to finish 6th. Travis is set in 3rd, but he could fall all the way to 6th. 3rd is a podium finish. 3rd is top 5. You finish 3rd, you can build on that. You finish 6th, it's nowhere near what it would be to finish 3rd. So as a racer, it's only 3 spots, but it's bigger than you could imagine.
We're going to ride along with a few different trucks, one of those being the Fastenal Dodge of Dennis Setzer. He'll start in the 34th position. We carry one of our cameras.
All right, Ray Bestis, rookie leader. Willie Allen will start his number 13 Thor Sport Chevrolet from the 27th position.
You got Ted Musgrave running around, riding around here. Won the race 2 weeks ago, starts 17th tonight.
Travis Quaffle, we spotlighted him. He's 3rd in the points, can't move up, but could move back. He starts 10th tonight, carries one of our cameras.
Our point leader, Mike Skinner, we've talked about him all evening long. He's going to start this race from the 4th position.
Let's head back trackside. Adam Alexander, what do you think before the green flag flies?
Well, we all know it's all about what happens tonight between Mike Skinner and Ron Hornaday. But how do these two drivers compare here at the Homestead Miami Speedway? Let's take a look. They have combined for 12 starts at this mile-and-a-half facility, and here are the numbers. Only one win. That's the best finish for Ron Hornaday. Skinner, a 4th. It happened a couple of years ago. But what about the average finish? This really the telltale sign. Skinner, a 15.4, 6.4 for Ron Hornaday. But you know what? That's all history now. The guy who has the best finish tonight, Ray, could very well be celebrating the 2007 NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series Championship.
Well, and Adam, throughout the week and on all of our shows here on Speed Channel, we have been talking about the fact that there is an X factor in tonight's race, and that is the guys who aren't running for the championship, but there may be a big factor in that, and I think Kevin Harvick will be a big part of that. He was certainly last week in Phoenix. We know that Harvick will win this race tonight if he can. He's certainly going to try to lead the most laps if Hornaday can't do that, and I think we'll keep our eye on that too tonight to find out who is going to be the champion. Krista?
Well, Ray, continuing our championship final thought segment here. During the pre-race, something I noticed, Bill Davis Racing drivers, they had kind of an informal team meeting. Jacques Villeneuve, Dave Blaney, Mike Skinner, and Johnny Benson all went behind Victory Lane, talked for a little bit. They all walked out to go their separate ways. Mike Skinner and Johnny Benson were walking next to each other, but not talking to each other. Now, that's really no big deal. Obviously, they're focused on their trucks. But again, an informal team meeting right before they got in their race trucks tonight.
They might have should have had that last week, Rick.
Well, just 4 points was all that Mike Skinner lost, and I say all that Mike Skinner lost. If it comes down to 4 points at the end of the race, those are going to be mighty important four
but
points.
Just think about how nice it would have been not to have had to have had that distraction all week. If these guys could have just focused on their race instead of worrying about what happened last week, they might be more prepared tonight.
Guys, look at that front row. John Wood has elected to start on the outside. He got the pole. It's his option whether to start on the inside or the outside. He chose the outside.
John Wood on the outside, our pole sitter. Track record holder on the inside, it's Johnny Benson. The final race of the 2007 season is underway.
You can see Mike Skinner got a great start right there, Phil. He drove really closely up to the back of John Wood, got around Johnny Benson. He's going to go for those 5 points early.
Yeah, I think Johnny Benson backed off a little bit to let Mike Skinner get up there and see if he could get those 5 points early.
John Wood doesn't want anything to do with letting someone buy him, so he has the point as they go into turn number three.
If I'm Mike Skinner, I go find John Wood before this race starts and say, hey, buddy, how you doing?
What do you think about me getting a couple bonus points?
I mean, I'm not sure you want to stretch yourself early in the going. Hey, Kyle Busch said in the setup show you can't pass. Did you see that? They were spread four wide across this track.
I wondered exactly what he was talking about. We see some side-by-side racing already here. Ron Hornaday has moved up to the outside. That's his teammate, Kevin Harvick, right behind him.
Now, can you imagine the amount of assumptions we make to think that it's just going to come down to these two racing each other? We could have a flat tire. We could make an unscheduled pit stop. The caution could fly at a weird time. You could spin out. These things are easy to crash. We saw them crashing on the front straightaway at Phoenix last week. This is so tense just not to make a mistake and take a championship away from yourself.
Two and three wide, and right now backing up is that 27 of Jacques Villeneuve. He had a great qualifying effort, but it looks as though he can't get up to speed, and he's got his hands full.
Well, you can see that thing's getting out from under him, Phil. That's a loose truck he's trying to drive.
Great battle for third right there. Johnny Benson, the 23 on the inside of Eric Darnell. It looks like, ooh, Eric's going to fight back on the outside. There's Hornaday right behind him.
One of our championship contenders now, Ron Hornaday, running in the top five, but the guy he's chasing, Mike Skinner, running second right now to John Wood. Jacques continuing to have troubles as he backs through the field. What's going on, Adam?
Started third and already back to the 14th position in three laps. He came over the radio and said, I'm way too loose. And as he says that, Ted Musgrave looking for racing room underneath of him.
Here comes that 51 truck of Kyle Busch. Winner of two of the last three races. He gets by Musgrave right down on the bottom of the racetrack. Look at Jacques Villeneuve up there continuing to get sideways and chase that truck all over this racetrack.
What's happened, though, at this point, Phil? We've run four laps, and you can see Hornaday there underneath Darnell looking at the bottom. These guys are comfortable now. You know, they took the green flag. They fired that thing off in turn one, understood what it felt like, and now they've got a comfort level up under them. Phil, or excuse me, Ray, what are they saying about the 33 truck?
Well, Michael, just wanted to refer to earlier today. You know, we had practice and they got ready to go qualifying. Rick Wren wanted to only do one qualifying run, but he had to do two because on the first qualifying run, Hornaday's truck was way too loose, and it was pretty loose on the second run. So they dropped the track bar significantly to try to tighten up that Camping World Chevrolet. And Rick Wren told me right before the race, he said, we can always add spring rubbers or do some air pressure adjustments to loosen this thing up if we need to, but we wanted to make sure it was tight enough for him to roll it through the corners. And Hornaday so far has said he's very, very happy with the way the truck is running.
And Ray, that's a great adjustment for them to make, because that is one thing that you can do in the limited amount of things that you can do. As you see Ron Hornaday go for the third spot of Eric Darnell, you can move that track bar back up.
But if you watch qualifying for the Truck Series on Speed today and listen to Ron Hornaday after that lap, he said, whoo, that's all I wanted. I mean, he was nervous about that lap. He thought he maximized, got all he could out of that truck, and now he's driven up to the third spot.
Going to bring his teammate with him. Yeah. Kevin Harvick's going to try to follow him by.
And team owner Kevin Harvick is going to get by Eric Darnell as well. And so those Camping World Chevrolets staying nose to tail around this mile and a half racetrack, all trying to chase that number 21 of John Wood, who really has checked out on this field. Mike Skinner over 2 seconds behind John Wood, and we've just completed seven laps of racing from Homestead Miami Speedway. The championship is all up in the air as we close in on the final laps.
The NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series on Speed is presented by the Ford F-150, built for tough. Brought to you in part by the official tools of NASCAR, Craftsman, and by Fastenal. We get it right.
John Wood holding on to that top spot, increasing his lead over Mike Skinner. 2.5 seconds now separate Wood from Skinner. John Wood set the track record earlier today in qualifying, 31.180, took David Rudiman off of the track record holder list.
What we have right now is a problem for Ron Hornaday, because Mike Skinner's running second. Ron Hornaday's 29 points behind him going into this race. He's going to have to finish in front of him.
And right now, the only spot in front of Mike Skinner is the leader.
Justin Marks spins coming off turn number two. Caution flag is out.
Looks like he got that thing up and underway, Phil, without running anything. Something interesting happened the lap before that caution. Harvick drove around the outside of Hornaday. Now, you say that's teammates. Why'd he do that for? It's Harvick found a better line. He found himself being able to run on the outside of the racetrack. He knew that it would be smart for him to drive away from Hornaday, drive around Hornaday, and show him there's more than one place to run on this track.
Take a look at this. Yeah, Justin Marks getting turned around coming out of turn number two.
Yeah, you can see some black marks there. That probably, you can see him all the way back to where it started. He had a truck right behind him. I don't think there was any contact there. Just loosen him up a little bit. Took a little air off the rear spoiler.
That's a great example of aero loose. The truck behind him just took the air away from his spoiler and sent him spinning through the grass.
First caution of the day comes out on lap number 15. It's Justin Marks that brings out the yellow flag. That closes the field up on John Wood. Sunday, you're not ready for the green flag until you see NASCAR Race Day, built by the Home Depot. Tune in as the Race Day crew gets you pumped up for Homestead. The final race of the season. Don't miss NASCAR Race Day, built by the Home Depot, Sunday, 12:30 p.m. Eastern, live exclusively on Speed. Chris DeVota.
Kyle Busch was in down on this end. He had been complaining about a tight race truck, so he came in trying to even out the sides. He made an air pressure adjustment, also two rounds in the right rear, trying to even out his truck. Also, Dennis Setzer in down on my section.
Jacques Villeneuve was in after starting third. He had dropped like a rock. Loose the call early for him. Four tires, fuel, a chassis, and an air pressure adjustment. He will restart in the 28th position. Ray?
One lap before the caution came out, Kevin Harvick went around Ron Hornaday. The reason they're doing that, he wants to show him the line that he's been taking. The two has actually been able to roll his truck up a little bit higher in the center. Hornaday is going to try to follow him a little bit and see how it works out for the 33.
So obviously the two of them are going to work together to see if they can get to the front.
Well, that's an example of a teammate passing the guy racing for a championship for good reasons. He wanted to show him a new line around this racetrack. Kevin felt like he saw something on the top that Ron could benefit from. If I'm Mike Skinner, though, Phil, right now I'm feeling really good about this championship. We ran some 15 laps under green, and his truck stayed solid. He's been falling off here the last couple weeks. You run a few laps under green, his truck fades. But tonight, he seems like he's got a good truck. If I'm Skinner, I'm feeling pretty good about this championship right now.
In addition to the fact that Ron Hornaday was passed by his teammate, now Kevin Harvick may run up there and try to jump up there and race with Mike Skinner a little bit, maybe get in front of Mike Skinner.
Well, in order to do that, he's got to pass Skinner's teammate, who passed Skinner last week. So I hope people watching at home ain't as confused as I am, because I know Mike Skinner and I know Ron Hornaday. They don't care about all that. They're going to run those trucks as hard as they can and let everything else take care of itself.
And that's exactly what John Wood is thinking. I'm going to let those guys do whatever they want back there. I'm going to continue to lead this race. Green flag back out here in Homestead.
Look at that. Johnny Benson had got a very poor start. Kevin Harvick jumps to the inside.
Now let me ask you a question. If we're going to be Monday morning quarterbacks, did he do that on purpose? Did he get a bad start? No payback. Just to let.
No. Layback.
Look at John Wood move over to allow Mike Skinner to get by. He's going to let him get by and lead this lap here. Lead this race. Get 5 points.
They see, now I'm really confused. What does John Wood have to do with this?
I just started to say that John Wood could care less who wins this championship, and I'll be darned if he doesn't pull over and let Mike Skinner go by.
Well, here comes Ron Hornaday. He's able to get back by his teammate and team owner, Kevin Harvick. Harvick dropping back a bit.
Well, if I'm Skinner, I say, okay, Johnny, last week was bad.
But that was a good restart, what you just did there. You bought me some, you bought me a gap. Now I'm leading the race.
Coming inside to the quarter.
Dave Blaney looking to the inside now on that number 22.
Clear.
Blaney a little bit hesitant as he enters the corner. We've seen so many trucks lose control on the inside of another truck. He backed off a little bit so he didn't lose that air off the rear spoiler.
That's what I'm talking about, NASCAR racing. How are you going to figure out how to win a championship other than just hammer down? How do you know if you're on Hornaday that John Wood, of all people, is going to pull over and let Skinner lead the race? You can't figure that out.
Dave Blaney trying to make the move up toward the front. Career best of six at Dover, but that was back in 2004. Ray, is he going to improve on that tonight?
Well, he hopes to, but early on, he was very, very loose. He said the truck was hard to hold on to, but it took about 10 or 11 laps before he was able to actually get that thing going. And now he says the truck is very neutral, so loose early and then neutral.
John Wood, meanwhile, has given up the second position to the 23 of Johnny Benson.
Now, if Bill Davis Racing learned anything from last week, let's hope that they've learned to tell Johnny Benson to follow Skinner. Skinner's leading the race. If he can lead the most laps, that's another 5 points. There's no reason for Johnny Benson to drive up around the leader of this race and take points away from him. You can see here as Quapple dives to the inside of Hornaday.
We're very close. It got Travis Quapple really loose. Ron Hornaday did a little side drafting on him. Got him really, really loose that time.
Adam Alexander.
The call from Quapple in the early going, I need more grip. After starting 10th, he's jumped up into the top five. But as you can see, a shaky race truck racing for position on the track with both Dave Blaney and Ron Hornaday out in front of him, guys.
Well, it is a shaky race truck because Hornaday was aggressive on him on that lap. Did you see that, Phil, as he raced up to turn one?
Let's watch that, Mike. Let's watch this replay of the six of Travis Quapple on the inside. He's going to get on the inside, coming off turn number four, Ron Hornaday. Watch when we get down to turn number one. Ron Hornaday is going to pull over and side draft on him and really get him loose, Michael.
Hey, I mean, he thinks he's in good shape. He thinks he's got the pass made, but here comes Hornaday. You see that truck turn sideways? That's all done with air. He just ripped the air off the side of that truck, and Quapple almost spun out.
Dave Blaney, meanwhile, is going to move up in front of the six of Travis Quapple.
So across the start-finish line, John Wood has dropped back into the third spot now. It's Skinner, Benson, and John Wood, Krista.
Well, guys, John Wood is dropping back, but don't be too alarmed. He actually came on the radio and told his team, hey, guys, don't worry about it. I just want to see how my truck drives in traffic.
That's a good idea to do that now.
I would have rather seen if I could lead every lap here. Look at what
subs wrong with my truck. The five of Mike Skinner. He slows on the racetrack. What's going on, Ray?
He's got a tire down. He just said, we got a pit. Guys are getting up on the wall right now. He did not come to pits that time, but he said it's a flat tire.
We talked about a bad break affecting the outcome of this championship. Here, Mike Skinner, 25 laps into this race.
As they cross the start-finish line, 39 points separated Skinner and Hornaday in the championship battle.
This is very tense times right now, Phil. Right now he just has a flat.
Once you get around here, keep digging. But if he
goes too fast, that flat could turn into a flying piece of rubber that'll rip the fender right off that truck.
With a lucky dog, this is not that big a deal. He knows he can get a lap down. He knows he can get it back. He's got a fast enough truck. He's got a flat right front tire.
It doesn't look flat.
I don't see it. I don't see that tire being flat. You can usually tell.
He comes down pit road. He's moving quickly on pit road. He's got to watch his speed, right?
Well, and they wanted to get here, as you said, to make sure he doesn't rip a fender up. But Jeff Hensley's doing the exact same thing. He's looking all over the truck to try to make sure that it is on the right sides. The left side tires are completely up. No problem here, so they'll do right sides only.
That tire's up. The right front that just came off is up.
Maybe he had a loose wheel or something. We've seen some wheels get loose before.
Push it. All the way to call. There
you
go.
That's something that he might not have taken into consideration. Maybe the left side wheel was loose, not low. And maybe that right front tire was soft, but it certainly looked like it had a lot of air in it.
We have a new championship leader. Ron Hornaday now has a 76-point lead over Mike Skinner as they run on the racetrack. Hornaday running third now. Johnny Benson is your race leader. Hornaday now moves to second behind Johnny Benson.
But if you're sitting at home and you're wondering, oh, 76 points, it's over. No, it's not. Aaron's is giving a lucky dog to a truck who's the first guy a lap down. Mike Skinner is that guy right now. And even if he doesn't get it the first time around, he's got a fast truck. He'll get that lucky dog. He'll rebound from this flat tire.
Meanwhile, there's Dave Blaney in the 21 of John Wood battling. That is a battle for the third position.
These two continue the side-by-side battle, and our championship battle continues between Skinner and Hornaday. Who could have ever imagined that a low tire could send Mike Skinner to the back of the field at the start of this race?
And right now, guys, there's only one truck a lap down, and that's Mike Skinner. If the caution flag comes out now, Mike Skinner will get the lucky dog and get back on the lead lap.
We just got to get down to those pits after this break and find out if that tire was flat or what happened.
JB out in front of the field, Hornaday, John Wood, Dave Blaney, and Harvick, your top five. Welcome back. The Ford 200 continues here at Homestead Miami Speedway. Johnny Benson out in front of this field. Ron Hornaday runs second. The championship still in question now as Mike Skinner has had problems with his right side tires. He came onto pit road. We're not sure if that problem has been resolved.
He's running very competitive lap times. He's among the two or three fastest trucks on the racetrack each and every lap. You can see right now the point differential, 81 points. The bad news for Mike Skinner is Andrew Myers now has been lapped. So if the caution were to come out now, Mike Skinner would not get the lucky dog, Ray.
And Phil, the Goodyear engineers were immediately over here to take a look at these Wranglers, and they decided that the tires were obviously not down and not equalized. But Mike Skinner got on the radio and wanted some communication with his crew chief, Jeff Hensley.
What happened, Jeff? It wasn't down, buddy. It looked good. It was not down. Just keep digging, buddy. We'll get the lucky dog here in a minute.
Oh, trust me. It was fixing to blow, buddy. I promise you. Maybe it equalized.
Okay, bud.
That's when it's real important for the crew chief to be a cheerleader and say, well, we can't see anything wrong with it, but if you felt that, I'm glad you came to pit road. Hey, he's not going to get the lucky dog right now. I didn't figure he would. When you have slow trucks on the track, Andrew Myers has already been lapped. Dennis Setzer's truck is off the pace. He will not get it now, but eventually he'll get the line up on the inside of the leaders and pass the guys that aren't as fast as him, and he will get this lap back.
That's if we have a caution.
Oh, Aaron's will
ensure
that.
Hey, Michael, I want to add to that, though. Just remember, as you said, how many times in the past couple of seasons have we seen Mike Skinner blow a right front tire, go into the wall, and this year, throughout this season, so many times they've gone error on the caution side, and it's paid off for him to put him in this position. So Skinner had a feel for something wrong with the truck, but apparently it's gone away.
I love what he did, Ray. That was the smartest thing in the whole world to do. It's too early in the race to take a chance.
Battle for fifth. Travis Quappel taking it away from John Wood. A strong truck early on for John Wood, and now he continues to lose spots on the racetrack. You know, touching back to Mike Skinner and the problems that he used to have, in any race that has been over 200 miles in the history of the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series, Mike Skinner has only won four of those races out of the 24 that he has won. Three of them came this year, races that were 200 miles or longer. So he's really raced smarter this year.
He's matured. I mean, we saw him last week when we were in Phoenix, and the week before in Texas, and the way he raced at Martinsville, he has matured. He's ready to win the championship. His team, however, gave away some points last week by their mistake on pit road. And I talked to some of those guys on that team earlier today, and they're still in denial. They said that was Harvick's fault. It was not Harvick's fault.
Not at all. And they also changed the jackman. That was in question last week. It looked like the jackman had a problem. They've got Dave Blaney's cup jackman jacking that truck tonight.
So we've seen it takes a team. It takes a team and a driver to win a championship. Skinner's ready to win. His team cost him some points last week. Maybe they can help him get them back this week.
Eric Darnell fighting to stay in the top 10, Adam.
And he's been the yo-yo tonight, Rick. Started sixth, jumped to third, now back to seventh, and looking to go by John Wood for the sixth position. He was tight, center off, and now he said it's starting to free up, and perhaps the reason why, watch the line that Darnell runs through the corner. A couple of grooves off the bottom, and my question is to our drivers in the booth, how much can you move around at this racetrack to help the handling of your truck?
Adam, you can move all the way from the bottom to the top of this racetrack. This is one of the best ideas that a racetrack ever had doing this progressive banking, Michael.
And you can change the handling of your truck drastically by doing that, Phil. If you're a little bit free, you can dive to the bottom of the racetrack. Or if you're a little bit tight, you can sweep around the top. And this banking in the corners complements what you're trying to do with your truck. So these guys are able to venture out, look around. And that's why I love this track so much.
Eric Darnell searching for a different line around the racetrack, trying to get his truck to handle just a bit better. He's got that Garmin number 8 right behind him with Chad McCombie. Johnny Benson chasing down Donnie Leah in the number 59. Donnie Leah going a lap down to the field. Now a lap down is Donnie Leah. Also Chris Jones, Andy Lally, Dennis Setzer, and Andrew Myers join Mike Skinner a lap down. So if the caution does come out, Skinner does not receive the free pass. Johnny Benson continuing to lead here at Homestead. The Speed Performance Awards driven by BF Goodrich. It's the only motorsports awards show where you, the fan, can pick the winners from best finish to temper. Beginning Monday, log on to speedtv.com, pick your category, and cast your vote. The Speed Performance Awards driven by BF Goodrich.
You know, guys, one thing we haven't talked about, we don't get a whole bunch of green flag pit stops here in the Craftsman Truck Series. These races are so short. But Mike Skinner pitted with that unscheduled pit stop on lap number 27. You can probably go somewhere between 55 and 60 laps when you're full of fuel. So he can go probably another 40 laps. But these other guys actually, you know, had qualifying and pace laps when they started this race. So they're probably looking to pit probably in the early 50s. So we may be just 5 laps away as we see Brendan Gaughan, our fast and all fast start. Brendan's made a nice start from the 22nd position up to the 11th spot. But some of these guys may be getting ready to pit. That may put Mike Skinner back on the lead lap, Mikey.
That's why it's so important for Skinner right now to pass every truck he can see. Because some of the trucks he's passing right now coming up from the back of the field are guys that did make a pit stop on our first caution. So therefore, he knows they'll stay out. He needs to get ahead of all them.
There's a lot of weapons in front of us.
Talking about the traffic he's looking at. So those guys will stay out a little bit longer. He needs to pass every one of them. So in 5 or 6 laps, when these lead trucks start pitting, maybe it cycles back to putting Skinner on the lead lap without having to use the air's lucky dog.
Yeah, right now the Kyle Busch is one of those trucks that pitted on lap number 16. He's up in the 14th spot.
John Wood has hands full moments ago as the double zero of Andy Lally caused a problem.
This is scary. Watch this.
Andy Lally makes a little contact with a one of Jason Leffler, and John Wood was really heads up to drove all the way up to the top of the racetrack.
Chris Devoto.
Well, they just asked John Wood what kind of adjustment he'll want. He said a pretty big one. Back on lap 40, he said his truck was getting really tight. Now he said it is loose in. They are planning on coming in around lap 58. 7 more laps, guys.
Yeah, that's going to be interesting to see how this all happens, guys.
They're coming into their pit window now. We said it was going to be anywhere from 55 to 60 laps would be the pit window. And we had the one caution, just a few caution laps, so that might extend their window just a few laps.
Yeah, and remember, they have the fuel that they used qualifying. They were not able to top these trucks back off, plus 3 pace laps. So most of the guys, when they say they can run 60 laps, that means from full of fuel. Now they're looking at probably 55 if they have to start the race with the fuel burned out.
Second place, Ron Hornaday has team owner and teammate right behind him, Kevin Harvick. That is a battle for the second spot. Harvick running a little higher line than Ron Hornaday is around this racetrack.
And we've seen that all night long. Kevin's been up top, Ron down low, and look at the run Harvick gets off the corner. That's what that top line does for you. It gives you a whole lot of momentum when you exit the corner, and look at the run he made on his teammate.
And Kevin is typically not a guy that really likes the outside of the racetrack. He's one of the guys that really would like to run the bottom. There's our first of our lead lap trucks on pit road. Chad McCombie, he had driven up into the top 10, Ray.
Yeah, and absolutely, Phil. He's real happy with the truck. The only problem is he can't get it all the way up in the high line, and that's where he sees the other trucks seem to be going a little bit faster. So they wanted to make an adjustment to try to loosen him up just a little bit to see if he can get up there and change the line for that Garmin Chevrolet.
Now, this is all good for Skinner right now. These guys are pitting, and he knows that everyone that pits, that's a better chance of him getting back on that lead lap. This is a tense time for Jeff Hensley and those guys on pit road, wondering what's going to happen.
And how about Kevin Harvick? He just went by his teammate, Ron Hornaday. We may be in the exact same situation where Ron Hornaday may watch Kevin Harvick and see Kevin goes right back to the top of the racetrack, but Ron goes right back to the bottom. I think Kevin is trying to show him that line.
And Ron's saying, you're going to have to show me. I like it down here pretty good.
I was going to say, it looks like Ron may be a little more comfortable down on the bottom of the racetrack. Eric Darnell now making his way around the access road and onto pit road. So we're seeing more of the green flag pit stops. There were 14 that stayed on the racetrack and did not come in on that first caution.
And that's who's pitting right now. And we talked about a minute ago, Hornaday was some 80 points behind. Now as these trucks pit at him, he's only 64 behind.
It's a little bit early for Eric Darnell. They wanted to wait a few more laps, but he felt the vibration, so they're going to go ahead and bring him in. Tight center off the call for that Ford. It's going to be four tires and fuel. The pit stop at lap 56, and you can see pitting a couple of stalls in front of him. Jason Leffler, four tires, fuel there. They're also getting an air pressure adjustment. He was tight from the center off. Both guys down and away under green. Krista?
The pole sitter, John Wood, comes in. He wants his truck to tighten up. They're going to do it with track bar adjustment. Two rounds down, four tires.
33 is here. Ron Hornaday brings his Camping World Chevrolet in for the first time. Now remember, Danny Stockman, who normally hangs tires on the front, is the truck chief, but he is not going over the wall. Instead, it'll be Jeff Roth. We'll keep an eye on the crew. Everything was smooth on the right side. They go to work over here on the left. Jack Mann's got the tires away. Everything a nice, smooth stop, getting plenty of fuel in it. Hornaday back to the racetrack.
Good stops for Hornaday and John Wood. There comes Johnny Benson now. Johnny Benson will relinquish the lead.
Well, you have to swing around and say advantage Skinner now, Phil.
Absolutely. It's going to be interesting to see what the points are once Ron Hornaday gets back around to the start-finish line and the scoring recycles.
Ron Hornaday right now falls back behind Skinner when we're talking about points. Skinner now up 28 points on top of Hornaday. Right.
Johnny Benson, number 23, comes in. He is talking about being a little bit tight through the center. We also know that Kevin Harvick is on his way. He'll pit back behind Benson about two stalls. They have a little bit of a hang-up on the right front on Johnny Benson's truck, so that is going to cost them valuable time. Benson will not get through with a quick stop because it will be four tires for that Exide Toyota.
This is exactly what I'm talking about. Now,
Travis Quaffle on pit road, Michael. They had issues on a green flag stop here coming at lap 59. A team that is usually spot on. He was complaining about no grip and tied off. Four tires and fuel, but a slow stop for the six will cost him a great deal of track position. Ray?
Adam, look at all the grass that's on the front end of the Lumber Liquidators Toyota. Ty Bodine apparently had run through the grass somewhere. They'll get that cleared off, and Bodine with four tires. Boda?
Brendan Gaughan says his truck is very tight. A four-tire change and an air pressure adjustment for Brendan Gaughan in the South Point 77.
As all this continues to cycle through, John, Dave Blaney actually came in. He was your leader, and now Jacques Villeneuve out in front, right?
Yeah, and here comes Dave Blaney. That Caterpillar truck has been really, really good. He has been very happy with the way that thing's been handling. No adjustments scheduled right here. As this crew will go to work over on the left side, they want to make sure they pack this thing full of fuel. As you guys said, how long will we go in a long green flag run? Nice stop on the right side here for Blaney's guys. It'll be four tires here, and as I said, no adjustments on the Caterpillar Toyota.
Go, go, go.
Well, there's our point contenders right there. Mike Skinner on the inside. Ron Hornaday, remember, Hornaday has pressure tires. That's obvious right there. And look at the points as of now. Remember when Skinner was 80 points behind a few moments ago?
It's like every week of the championship battle. Somebody new surfaces on the top. He went from 80 down. Now he's 30 up. But did you see the ground he lost to Hornaday in one corner? That means he's giving away time now. So for a while, Skinner was praying that the caution doesn't fly. And now he's saying,
please give me the caution.
I need it to fly now.
I'm telling you right now, though, I think Mike Skinner and Ron Hornaday find themselves a lap down because a lot of trucks have not pitted yet. So I don't think either one of those trucks wants a caution until everyone else that pitted on lap number 16 comes down pit road.
And if I'm Bill Davis Racing, I bring that truck right there to pit road right now. That's one less guy on the lead lap ahead.
Jacques Villeneuve is your leader. He has a half a second lead over Kyle Busch. There are 15 trucks still scored on the lead lap here at Homestead Miami Speedway. The championship battle continues to heat up. Welcome back to the Ford 200. Your new leader is the 51, Kyle Busch. He's now out in front. Jacques Villeneuve has dropped back into the second spot.
Here's how it happened just a few moments ago. You see Kyle was running really well on the outside, but he dips down to the inside, drives by that 27 truck of Jacques Villeneuve and takes over the lead. Now Kevin Harvick goes after that 51 of Kyle Busch to try to unlock himself.
Again, Kyle Busch out in front. You take a look at his progression through this field. If you're just tuning in, our championship has really seesawed back and forth in just this race. I know it did five races in a row, but in just this race, it's gone back and forth. And it started when Mike Skinner had problems on lap 27.
And it's getting ready to get even more intense, Rick, because Mike Skinner needs a caution right now. He comes to pit road with a flat tire, or what he thought was a flat tire. The team says, we don't see anything. You got to remember, Skinner blew a few tires over the years. He knows what he feels. And he came to pit road, his team said nothing, sir.
Michael, he was dead last when he made that pit stop. You see him right here, he's running in the 18th position. The problem is, we've got a number of trucks led by Kyle Busch, our leader, that pitted on lap number 16. They have not made their green flag pit stop yet. So Mike Skinner right now finds himself one lap down, as well as that 33 truck right there, Ron Hornaday.
But these trucks, the trucks that stayed out, are getting ready to start coming to pit road. We're going to see 14 trucks over the next five or six laps pit, which is going to run Hornaday all the way from 18th and Skinner all the way from their positions back in the late teens up into the top five. But quickly, Skinner's going to need to come to pit road. So he's still thinking, what's going to happen with the caution flag? I need some help over here.
How do I get on the same pit cycle right now as Ron Hornaday is on? 22 points separate our two championship contenders. Skinner back in front, but Skinner on a lot older tires. And we're still hearing that he feels a vibration with that truck, so he's not comfortable in his truck right now.
He would take his lumps right now. Hornaday's a lap down, and he's not the free dog. Skinner's a lap down. He would take his lumps and lose a lap right now, stay on the same page with Hornaday, and get to pit road and put some tires on that thing.
See, Michael, I don't think I would want to do that, because then you catch it. You take a chance of Hornaday being better than you and him getting the next Aaron's lucky dog. Actually, Ron Hornaday right now is the next truck in line.
Whoa, hang on, Skinner!
Loose, big time loose.
Almost loses it right there again. Well, you're hearing him say the right rear is flat, but it looks
easy.
Up.
I see smoke
no,
out.
I wouldn't say that. He can feel that. If that right rear is flat, he's going to know it. He, like I said, Phil, he wants a caution.
Hey guys, let's get forward this time. But
he wants it right now worse than anything in the world.
Anything in the absolute world, because he would catch Ron Hornaday down a lap if the caution were to come out right now. I'll tell you, if Mike Skinner has to make another unscheduled pit stop like this, we know that the lead lap trucks that were pitting just recently can stay out a long time. Chances are they're going to catch a caution flag. This may be it for Mike Skinner's championship hopes right here.
There goes Ron Hornaday right by the 50. And there goes the left rear off of the 5. It's Mike Skinner having trouble. The caution flag will fly.
This is not good for Skinner, though.
The whole wheel came off of the left rear.
Yeah, left side wheel is off, left side.
That is still not a big break, although Mike Skinner did beat Kyle Busch to the start-finish line, but he has not made his pit stop yet.
He's going to be two laps down and out of whack to get the free pass. All he can do now, Phil, is race for that lap back and get himself into position.
But guys, what about the damage to the left rear of this truck?
Chances are it didn't hurt anything, and chances are that's what he felt earlier. He knew something wasn't right. They changed too. That left rear was a little loose. Ray, what did they say to the pit?
Well, Michael, I just looked at it as the truck rolled by, and all the studs were on the left rear wheel, but now as they try to tighten it up, it looks like that wheel will not tighten on there, so apparently there is something wrong with the center section of that truck. So they're trying to run the lug nuts on there, but you can see that rear wheel will not tighten up. So that is going to be a problem that will probably require them to go behind the wall. And I believe you're right. This might be the end for Skinner's championship.
Yeah, they have a shot here to put a wheel spacer on that left rear field. And what that will do, it'll move the wheel out. And then that will allow some fresh threads to be grabbed by the nuts that go onto the studs. So they'll figure that out. That's what they're thinking about right now. And maybe they'll get that thing tightened up.
While they're thinking about it, the field continuing to put Mike Skinner laps down on the racetrack. And as he continues to go further down against the field, his championship hopes continue to fall.
Let's see if we can take a look back and watch, see what happened to that number five truck, Mike Skinner. You see Jeff Hensley right there on top of the box. See Mike Skinner. He knows he has a problem. You see that wheel wobbling a little bit there, and there it comes, just completely off that truck.
I've been there before, Phil. When the left rear tire wheel comes loose, you would promise it's a right rear flat because the thing just gets incredibly loose. And then the left rear tire and wheel fall off that truck. What was that came off
the hub?
Probably the dust cap. The dust cap that holds the axle in, I would think.
Well, that's not good.
No, that's not good.
Because then the axle can fall out.
Let's listen to this.
That's what you call loose. You don't need to hear Skinner talk because you can hear him working his foot. He's working his foot instead of his mouth. He was saying, whoa, I'm about to wreck here.
There's Jeff Hensley, his wife Angie.
What a terrific season they've had. Now, we're not going to call him out of it yet, but he's going behind the wall. So that now Ron Hornaday has to stay on the racetrack. Now he adopts a different strategy, Michael.
Oh.
Now all he has to do is stay on the racetrack because he sees this going on right here.
Now, the trucks that hadn't made pit stops yet, Kyle Busch leading the race, Jacques. Those guys pitted under that lap 14 caution, Phil, and now they've got a big break. Krista.
Momentum could be back in Kyle Busch's favor. When the caution came out, Richie Waters said, Kyle, I think we can go the distance now. They had made a stop earlier. It's a four-tire change. Kyle wanted the stickers. A little bit of confusion getting the right air pressures, but they think they can go the distance.
Both Jacques Villeneuve and Rick Crawford were going to come to pit road under green. Then the caution came out, giving these guys an opportunity to save fuel and pit under the caution. Each year getting four tires, fuel, and chassis adjustments to help the handling of their race trucks at lap 76.
You know, the important thing to remember is Ron Hornaday was able to unlap himself right before that caution flag that Mike Skinner's tire cost. So right now, Ron Hornaday, remember now, Mike Skinner came into this race with a 29-point lead. If both these guys have trouble, it's 3 points per position. Ron Hornaday would need to beat Mike Skinner by 10 positions because neither one of those two drivers have led this race.
Brian Scott, the lucky dog, Aaron's lucky dog. He'll get a lap back, and we'll be back for the green flag after this.
Welcome back to Miami. It's championship weekend, and Ron Hornaday came back to pit road to put a little splash of fuel in it. Rick Wren felt like they were too close on their window to make it to the end, and they say they're going to go the distance now. Meanwhile, Mike Skinner's number five truck sits back in the garage area, and they continue to work on it. Now, they are trying to change the left rear hub on this truck. Now, basically, there were two wheel studs that were broken on there and the center cap missing. As you said, Phil, we saw that wheel come loose. That'll do that. But two broken studs, so they've got to remove the entire hub and put a new one on it. They've got their crash cart back here. Chad Rainey, one of the crew chiefs, truck chief on here, is working on it. Jeff Hensley right there in the middle, and they're going to try to make repairs to Mike Skinner's Tundra. But Hornaday came to pit road so they can be sure to have enough gas to make it to the end.
You know, guys, this thing is not over because, Mike, I said earlier that neither one of these guys has led. We saw John Wood pull over, let Mike Skinner lead. So he has 5 bonus points. He was 29
Ready.
Points ahead coming in, plus Ready. 5. That's 34 points.
Great back, great
so
back.
That means that Ron Hornaday has to beat Mike Skinner by at least 12 positions in this race in order to pass him.
And may I tell you, Phil, in the middle of that glob sits Ron Hornaday. He came to pit road, got a little extra gas. Now he's in heavy traffic. These guys crash. He could be in the middle of it. It's never over until you get to the end of these things.
And that is why Skinner's team is working so diligently right now to get him back on this racetrack in case the 33 has problems.
I think right now that Ron Hornaday has to have a complete different philosophy for this race than he had earlier. Right now, he needs to stay away from all these trucks.
just let these guys settle it out here a little bit, get single file,
up top right now,
and then maybe pick them off one at a time. Try to stay on the lead lap. That's all he needs to do. Stay on the lead lap. Stay on.
Oh,
the
we got a spin ahead of him.
Problem. Jack Villeneuve gets turned around and into the wall in turn number one. Our third caution of the night comes out, and it looks as though Ron Hornaday, our championship contender, makes it through.
And he can breathe again as well.
That happened in front of him. Like you said, Phil, sometimes you might just say, I think I'll go to the back. That's all I need to do. I'll go to the back and hang out, stay on the lead lap, and then analyze what Skinner does when he comes out of the pit. You can see Jock, he just gets loose in the middle of traffic.
He's on the outside of a truck.
Up against another truck. The thing spun out.
Backs into the outside wall. Let's see if we can take a look. We're going to get a good tight shot of Jock right there. Look for Ron Hornaday. See if we can see him. See Willie Allen go by. There's the 10 of David Starr. Looks like Ron was already ahead of that.
Started out as a great night for Bill Davis Racing, but it's going downhill quickly.
Two trucks are out of the field now. Skinner battling to get back on the racetrack.
Coverage of the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series on Speed is brought to you by the official tools of NASCAR. Craftsman by Just for Men. Stay in the game with Just for Men hair color. And by Edge Products, the leader in performance electronics.
Welcome back. The championship picture was cloudy moments ago. It's clearing up just a bit. Our lucky dog going to Jason Leffler. Here's the lucky dog.
This is a result of a guy that had made a pit stop under the green, and some of the leaders hadn't, and so it trapped Leffler a lap down. He's got a fast truck, Phil.
Yeah, he worked his way up into the top 10. Ray, what's going on with Skinner?
Well, they've got the repair done here, Phil, already, believe it or not. They've changed the hubs. They've got the brake calipers back on. Chad Rainey putting on the lug nuts here, and what they're going to do is drop this left side of the truck, then they'll raise the right side to change tires over there, and you'll see that Bib Bruton's coming in here to make sure that they get everything torqued down real good this time, and they'll be ready to send Skinner back to the racetrack. Not sure how many laps he's lost here. You guys can probably figure that out on the scoring monitor, but within, I'd say, 35 seconds here, they'll be ready to get him back on track.
Yeah, Ray, he's being shown 10 laps down right now, and Michael, it begs the question, how did that left rear tire come off? Because they never changed that tire during the race. Remember when he made his unscheduled pit stop, he changed right sides only, and that left rear tire obviously came off. So was the wheel not torqued at the start of the race, or did they have a problem? You know, we have had some problems where the lug nuts didn't have the right taper, or the wheel holes where the lug nuts seat didn't have the right taper.
And that's the question that these guys are asking themselves. They've went around to everybody on the team. Did you torque the wheels? But when you're racing for a championship, we saw Skinner be conservative on the track. He wasn't taking any chances. When he had a tire that he felt was flat, he said right rear, his team said when he stopped, I don't see anything wrong with the left side tires. My brain was thinking, what if the wheel's loose? Let's get four. We'll take our chance, but that's the safest thing to do. And when you're racing for a championship and you have a 29-point lead when the race starts, you have to take advantage of every caution that you can.
And the damage was done because he was making an unscheduled pit stop anyway. Why not go ahead and change four tires? You're still only going to be one lap down. You would have been in exactly the same situation as they were. I think it was probably a miscue not changing four tires, and it bit them.
And it's easy for us to look back and say that, but the longer that the trucks run under green and the more that left rear tire wobbled back there on the wheel studs, it finally just broke everything back there and sent him to the garage.
Remember, we got a report that he still felt the vibration, and they'd run a number of laps after he changed right side tires, and he still felt the vibration because it was the left front.
The 100th race for the Toyota Tundra tonight, they're celebrating that fact. They wanted to celebrate it with the championship for that Tundra that Mike Skinner drives. That's certainly in question right now. He's 57 points behind as they run on the track right now.
Be ready.
And Kyle Busch is looking to make it three out of last four races go to victory lane. He leads as the green flag flies once again here at Homestead.
Did you see him fan out, Phil, behind him? All those guys are desperate to get that Aaron Lucky Dog. They want to get back in the fight. We only have some 12 trucks on the lead lap, so these guys know if they can get a lap back, then they can still have a good finish tonight.
Michael, I just saw Ron Hornaday go in the middle of a three-wide situation.
Are you sure?
I'm pretty sure I saw
he is not backing down. Neither is Dave Blaney on the bottom of the racetrack in that number 22. We see him 3 and 4 wide through the corners here at Homestead, Miami.
That's Ron Hornaday on the inside of a 3-wide battle right there.
The reason why I said, are you sure, Phil, is because there's Camping World Chevys all over out there. I've seen them. And yeah, that's Ron Hornaday right down on the bottom, battling with Johnny Benson, making up spots. Sometimes you don't want to deviate from your game plan. And Ron Hornaday's game plan, ever since he showed up racing truck, has been hammer down.
Ron Hornaday right now needs to complete 38 laps. He needs to make sure he gets inside of 11 laps of racing to go. Because right now Mike Skinner is being scored 36, but he is 11 laps down to this field.
But we watched Skinner rally from last place all the way up into the top 20. Well, he's last again. Can he rally again and snatch this championship away from Ron Hornaday?
3 wide. Terry Cook on the outside. Eric Darnell in that 99 was on the inside. And Ted Musgrave on the far inside in a Team ASE Toyota Tundra.
We're used to seeing that 92 truck, Terry Cook driving that 59 truck. Jim Harris brought two trucks here. Donnie Lee will drive that truck next year. They're going to get a head start on that. They brought a second truck for Terry Cook, and he makes his 247th consecutive Truck Series start here tonight.
That's quite a record there. He's won. He's finished in the top 10 in points, and now he's made 247 consecutive starts.
Diving into the middle there is that K&N Ford of Travis Quaple.
Travis is one of the trucks that's one lap down. We have 12 trucks on the lead lap right now. Kyle Busch, our leader, back to 12th place truck of Jason Leffler.
Phil, we've seen these truck races on speed turn into crash fests at some point late in the going. These guys know that these races are short, so they're patient for 40 or 50 laps, but it's time to go, and we're in that window now. There's no telling how the complexion of not only this race, but of this championship could change over the next 40, 50 laps. 40 laps.
45 laps to go. Kyle Busch still in front. Scored 13th. The first truck a lap down is Brendan Gaughan. Then it's Dave Blaney, Matt Crafton, Joey Clanton, John Wood, Todd Bodine, TJ Bell, and Travis Quaple. They are 13th through 20th. Out in front, it's Kyle Busch, Kevin Harvick, and Rick Crawford. Harvick and Kyle Busch continuing to battle on the racetrack. They were side by side just two laps ago, and here comes Harvick once again. You throw the 77 into the mix. Brendan Gaughan trying to race his way back onto the lead lap.
And he's the fastest truck out of all four of those trucks you're looking at, Phil. He's driven around Rick Crawford, and he got up beside Kyle Busch and just ran out of room on the top side. We know he loves the top side. Watch how high he goes in the corners.
Kyle's been running high, but nothing like what Brennan's running. And there's Dave Blaney. He's also a lap down, so he's racing Brendan Gaughan to try to get position to beat Aaron's lucky dog.
You can see Crawford diving to the bottom. Crawford's got a great truck. He's running the third spot there in the 14 down on the bottom. Kyle Busch just lost the lead to Kevin Harvick.
Right down on the bottom of the racetrack.
Kevin Harvick in front. Here comes the 77 of Brendan Gaughan. It looked as though he almost gave a shove to that 51 of Kyle Busch. Busch back on the high side trying to take the lead back.
Now Brendan's going to go through the middle here.
Brendan knows things are getting serious because he looked up and there's Dave Blaney right on his rear end. He knows he's got to make a move. He's got to figure out a way around Kyle Busch and to dispose of Kevin Harvick before Blaney puts him out of position to get the Aaron's lucky dog.
That would be amazing. As good a truck as Brendan Gaughan has right now, if Dave Blaney slipped by him and the caution came out, he would not get the lap back. Kristen, what's going on with Brendan Gaughan?
Brendan Gaughan has a very good truck, and he knew it coming in. Remember, they finished second here last year. He said after the test they had here in January, they knew they found something with these mile and a halves. Crew chief Brian Barry also has motivation for winning here. He is actually from Homestead. Yes, I said Homestead, not just Florida, not just the Miami area. He went to South Dade High School. Brian Barry is trying to get a win as a homecoming gift. Oh.
And how big would that be?
And Brendan Gaughan saying, what the heck? I'm right on the leader's bumper. Who is this man beside me? I can't even pass the leader and get the lucky dog. I got a guy wanting to beat me up for it.
Brendan Gaughan trying to race his way back on the lead lap. It's still Kyle Busch in front of this field. Amazing things have taken place up to this point as we've completed 97 laps of racing.
See, Kevin Harvick's going to pinch that 22 of Dave Blaney down a little bit. Dave didn't get in the throttle. He knew he would get loose down there underneath Kevin Harvick.
Look at this battle for the lead, Phil. We've only got some 30 laps to go, and there's seven or eight trucks. Some of them are lap down, but they're all in that battle for the lead.
See, the bright yellow truck, that's Matt Crafton. He's another one of the trucks that's a lap down. He wants to get up there and race that 77 and the 22 so he could get him a lucky dog. Three wide at the back.
Whenever lap that clicks by, Hornaday's breathing a little bit easier, sitting there riding in fifth spot.
Still there.
Got some 60 points over Skinner. Clear. Skinner's hoping for trouble. Hornaday's hoping for a smooth ride to the end.
Ron Hornaday would love to see green flag racing the remainder of this race. He knows he can make it on fuel. He made a quick stop under the last caution, came in and topped off on fuel just to give him a little bit of security.
I think if we don't go green white checker, I think every truck in the field right now can make it the rest of the way, because they all pitted on lap number 76, so that leaves 58 laps. So I really believe that they will all be able to make it the rest of the way, again, unless we have a green white check.
Very close there for Travis Quaffle and Todd Bodine.
They're beating up on each other there.
Ted Musgrave with a view of what almost was disaster.
Travis tried to do a little slide job on Todd. It didn't quite work out. See if he does it again. Doesn't quite have him cleared. He leaves Todd enough room on the high side.
This is for third. Johnny Benson taking it away from Kevin Harvick. This time it's Benson that passes Harvick.
This track promotes a slide job, Phil. The banking is progressive. You get a run on somebody, dive down to the bottom, you're going to want to slide up the hill, take advantage of that extra banking that's up the hill to complete that pass. So it promotes you to go down in there and do that. But if the guy on the outside doesn't want you to do that, we could see trouble.
Ron Hornaday making his way onto the inside of a lap down truck. That's Jack Sprague. Take a look at our point standings and what has taken place today. Ron Hornaday now leads Skinner by 63. Coming into the race, he was down 29 to Mike Skinner. What happened to Mike Skinner? Well, Mike Skinner lost a left rear wheel. Back on lap 74, this is what took place.
Early on, Mike Skinner was our leader. He had a vibration. He felt like he had a flat tire. He comes down pit road. They changed right side tires. He said his vibration never went away.
And you know, that's Skinner. We heard him on the telecast say, "Darn it, y'all, something is wrong." Well, that's what was wrong. The left rear wheel assembly broke off.
Again, Skinner coming into this championship battle, 29 points in front of Ron Hornaday. They spent considerable amounts of time behind the wall. They come back out and now 11 laps down to the field. So Mike Skinner hoping, obviously, to finish this race without any more problems. And if he has any chance at the championship, Ron Hornaday will have to have problems.
Remember, Ron Hornaday has to beat Mike Skinner by 12 positions, at least 12 positions, if it's 3 points per position. Right now, Mike Skinner runs in the 35th spot. That would mean Ron Hornaday has to finish 23rd right now to win this race. Right now, the 23rd place truck is only one lap down, and that's Terry Cook, who's running well. Any kind of problems for Ron Hornaday, it's back up for grabs.
A flat tire? Lose a cylinder? I mean, that's what I love about this sport. That's what I love about truck racing on speed. You never know what's going to happen. You got Kyle Busch leading the race. He was a lap down a little while ago. That tells you how quickly things can change.
Inside of 30 laps remain in the 2007 season, Hornaday looking for his third championship. Welcome back. Championship week continues. Starts right here, though, with the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series, as a championship will be decided tonight. Out in front of this field for the race is Kyle Busch, his Mikosuke Chevrolet.
That 23 truck, that X-Side Toyota, Johnny Benson, awfully fast. Johnny's running the bottom of the racetrack. Kyle's running up high.
Early in the going tonight, Phil, Kyle Busch looked mortal. He was running the 10th, 15th spot. We didn't know that he had a truck that is capable of doing what he's doing right now. Took advantage of some pit strategy, some great work in the pits by Richie Waters and those guys, and now he's leading the race.
Ray Dunlap, what's going on with our championship contender?
Well, Rick, you know, we talked a little bit about our preseason picks, and my story before we went to Daytona, I said I thought that Kevin Harvick Racing actually had matured to maybe become a championship team, but I thought that Rick Wren would be the X factor on that, and I believe that he really has been. But here's something to remember. Rick Wren actually worked for Bill Davis Racing last year, and he told me the reason he made the move is because Kevin Harvick is a true racer. He's a guy who understands what you need to get the job done. And Rick told me before the race tonight, he said Harvick has given him everything they needed to make this happen. He owes it all to his boss, man. Harvick's got a pretty good truck tonight, too, and he's telling Hornaday, just do what you're doing. Adam?
How about the resilient night for Justin Marks in only his fourth NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series start? He nearly missed the race and didn't qualify. Then in the first 15 laps, a spin bringing out the first caution of the night. But they've rallied back with great pit strategy from crew chief Jason Overstreet. And here they find themselves inside the top 10 late in the going. A career run for Marks tonight, a guy that will run for Rookie of the Year in 2008.
You know, we talked about...
Another battle going on down here. What about the rookie battle? Don't forget about Tim Sauter in that 07. He came into this race 7 points behind Willie Allen for that title. Willie Allen currently running 27th. Sauter is running 11th. Joey Clanton also in the mix. Sauter only 2 points ahead of him, but right now on the track, he's 6 positions ahead. Tim Sauter could be your new Ray Bestis Rookie of the Year.
Krista, we've got a great battle right there. There's a 07 of Tim Sauter, drives by that 46 of Scott Wimmer. First ever Truck Series start for Scott Wimmer, doing a great job. Just lost a top 10 right there, position two. Tim Sauter, and remember, this Tim Sauter is part of Greenlight Racing with Bobby Dotter, Gene Christensen. They don't know if they're going to race next year. Lester Buildings, we documented earlier in the qualifying show, is going away right now. They really don't have a regular deal going on the zero-weight truck. So Bobby Dotter told me right before the race, they're not sure they're even going to be around in 2008. It would be a shame to see a longtime team like Greenlight Racing go away.
Momentum on the side of Kyle Busch in that number 51. He has put 1 second between he and Johnny Benson running in second. Rick Crawford, Kevin Harvick, and Jason Lepley, your top five here at Homestead.
This restart is going to be the whole marbles here. Jeff Gordon's got to be careful that Sterling Marlin doesn't lay back and get a run on him on the back straightaway.
You ready? Green flag, green flag.
If they don't get by Jeff Gordon before they come around the next time, they will not pass it. And
Michael Waltrip. Jeff Green is involved.
Jeff Gordon spinning down the inside.
Gordon is in the grass. Caution flag is out. This could be the race to the finish of the Daytona 500. Two Dodges, drag racing, back to the caution flag. Who's going to get there first? Marlin by a nose.
The race is not over. They're going to red flag the event. They're going to stop the field, restart the race, and try and settle it.
Sterling Marlin has jumped out of his car. He's going around to look at the right front fender. But, oh, he can't do that.
You can't work on your car under the red flag. That's the NASCAR rule. Marlin's got to go to the back of the line. And Ward Burton's going to find himself leading the Daytona 500 when we go back green with about 3 laps to go.
Checkered flag is up, and Ward Burton is going to win the 44th Daytona 500.
Congratulations, you're the Daytona 500 champ.
Ward Burton, even I get a hug.
Speed's already gearing up for the 50th running of the Daytona 500 and Daytona Speed Weeks. Starting February 7th, Speed will have 100 hours of programming from the World Center of Racing, and it will all be in HD. 14 laps of racing to go here at Homestead.
You know what the greatest thing about that? Ray, what's going on with the two?
Apparently he has a tire going down. He just came on the radio and said, we've got nothing to gain here. He said, I don't want to wreck this truck. Remember, this is another brand new truck that they built for next year when Jack Sprague takes over the number two. So Harvick is talking about coming to the pits, and he may be going to the garage here.
Air on the side of caution is what Kevin Harvick will be doing, and I'm guessing that's exactly what Skinner will say later on this evening and probably the rest of this year before we start up in 2008.
If I'm Harvick, though, I go ahead and run within 10 laps of the finish, make sure I put my truck between Hornaday and Skinner to help that help that situation.
Yeah, right now we know that Mike Skinner is 11 laps down. If Kevin Harvick would stay on the racetrack, make sure he runs all but 10 laps, and he knows he's going to be between Ron Hornaday and Mike Skinner. And that's right. One of the 12 trucks that Ron Hornaday has to beat Mike Skinner by.
So I'd say Harvick will stay put for a few more laps anyway. Regan Smith there running in the nice spot, top 10 run. He does a good job in that truck, Bill.
He really does. He really has been competitive in this truck. This is the Morgan Dollar team. Ginn Resorts, the sponsor on this Chevrolet. Regan has done a nice job stepping in this truck.
You know, Bobby Ginn came into this sport and made a lot of news. A lot of it was negative, but I always liked Bobby Ginn. He loved this sport. He wanted to be a part of the sport in a big way. It didn't work out the way he hoped it did, but you can see him right here with Regan Smith honoring his commitment. And that's why Ginn Resorts is on the side of that truck, and that's why I like Bobby Ginn. He's a good dude.
Another guy that we've all come to like, Brian Scott. Another driver that will drive for Rookie of the Year in 2008. Started 24th and already running very well. Could be a career best for him, 11.
Yeah, Brian's doing a nice job. Only 19 years old, trying to get some experience and preparation for a rookie run next year in 2008.
What about our rookie battle next year? You got Justin Marks running along, having a great night tonight. He's an ace spot. And then you have Brian Scott. These guys could really battle it out next year.
What an unbelievable battle that we've got on the racetrack right now. Kyle Busch leading. Adam, what do you think about this young rookie?
Well, he's a great young kid and certainly humble at age 19. But you know, it's interesting when a guy becomes a race car driver, a lot of times he'll buy a motorhome to travel around the country and maybe hire his father to drive it for him. Well, a little bit of role reversal for Brian Scott. His dad, a successful businessman, has his own motorhome. So Brian drove it from Phoenix at last week's race here to Miami, 2,400 miles across country, and then hopped in the race truck for 200 miles here tonight that so far has been very successful.
Kyle Busch continuing to lead. We've gone inside of 10 laps to go, only 8 laps remaining. Kyle Busch has led 47 of the 125 that has run. We ride along with Mike Skinner. His woes started way back on lap 74. He thought he had a tire going down. Decided to make his way onto pit road.
He knew he had a problem. He was leading the race right then. He knew he had a problem. He came to pit road. He said, I'm telling you, I've got a flat tire. Something's wrong. The guys changed right side tires. He goes back on the racetrack, and later on, things got worse.
Well, we heard him say, now, guys, something is wrong. And unfortunately, here it is magnified. Something going bad wrong for this team. Sent him to the garage area. Lost 11 laps while effecting repairs. And he's hoping now for a lot of stuff to go on in the next 6-7 laps. Let me remind you, Rick, right now, this championship battle still isn't over. He can still win this championship if Hornaday has any sort of problem between now and the end.
Between now and 2 laps of racing to go, because we've got a number of trucks that are 2 laps down. We see the point differential between Ron Hornaday and Mike Skinner, 54 points now, Hornaday in front.
I think Ron Hornaday has to take the white flag on the racetrack to feel somewhat comfortable.
Yeah, he doesn't want to hear all the math. You know, at Aaron's, we do the math, and they do it pretty good. Ron don't want to be doing any math, Ray. He just wants to race, and he wants to tell them, he wants his crew to say, it's over, you won.
And he's just been hanging out right there, telling him to keep him an idea of how far back the number 30 truck is. You see Skinner in the picture right there. But you know, we want to talk about the overall season. We heard Ron Hornaday say earlier today that either one of these guys in any different season would have dominated. And I agree with that. An unbelievable season for both Skinner and Hornaday. But part of the reason that the 33 got where it was a great engine program from Richard Childress Racing. But what I've heard in the garage area this last weekend is that Richard Childress Racing will not be the engine supplier for Kevin Harvick and the Craftsman Truck Series next year. It appears that Pro Motor will be supplying the power plants for not only the 33, but also for the 2 truck in 2008.
Well, I want to tell you, if I'm Kevin Harvick, I own my own teams, and I owe a lot of thanks when we have success to Toyota for my engines. The engines are the cornerstone for any race team in NASCAR at this level. If I'm Kevin Harvick, I don't want to make that move. Childress has helped him win a championship. Childress has just won the owner's championship in Busch. He's got cars racing for the championship in Cup. I don't want to move away from that, Phil.
Yeah, that's a pretty unusual move. And we don't know all the ins and outs about what caused that move, but that is very interesting that that Kevin will not have RCR Motors next year.
Well, and if he doesn't have them next year, let's stop there. But let's think about what has brought Kevin Harvick Racing, put Kevin Harvick Racing on the map, and exactly why Kevin Harvick Incorporated is successful. I think he needs to pat Richard Childress on the back and say, thanks for giving me my roots, and hopefully I can grow from here.
Crossing the start-finish line, two laps of racing to go. It's Kyle Busch in front of Johnny Benson. That last time by the start-finish line, 1 second separated those two trucks. We heard earlier Johnny Benson was saying that he didn't have pressure. Oh, a problem spinning in onto the racetrack. The caution will come out. That means we will have a green-white checker finish to end the 2007 season.
And you know earlier, Rick, when we said when the white flag flies, Ron Hornaday can feel comfortable? Well, guess what?
It hasn't.
It ain't going to fly for a little while yet. We're going to have a caution. Then we're going to have a green-white checker. And so Ron Hornaday's thinking, oh, I didn't need that.
There's Chris Jones, the other green light racing Pirates booty. Gourmet snacks on board. There's Hornaday right there. He's going to have to put off his celebration for just a little bit here, his hopeful celebration.
Phil, let's watch, see why this fourth caution of the night has come out.
Chris just got a little bit loose down on the inside. He does a nice job saving that truck, really steered that thing the whole way. Never actually spun out. You see him getting on the brake, letting off the brake, kept that truck straight.
There was a moment in time, though, he felt sure he was going to hit that wall. And that's why he was driving so hard. He's like, I got to get it off that wall, because he was spinning and heading right for the inside wall. Saved it, not a scratch on that truck. Get him four more tires and finish this baby out.
Do a little green-white checker action.
It will be the sixth green-white checker of the 2007 season. Chris Jones trying to limp that truck back around the racetrack and put it onto pit road.
You know, guys, Ron Hornaday right now is in a perfect position. He is running seventh. He's the last truck on the lead lap. I'm telling you, if I was Ron Hornaday, I would lay back a half a lap and let these guys fight for it at the end.
Why wouldn't he?
I mean, what is he going to gain? Another spot or two? Maybe get a top five?
I'm sorry. Weren't you guys racers at one point? What do you mean, why wouldn't he?
It's easy to set
big
back.
Big picture.
It's easy to set back and guess, but that would be smart, but we're not that smart.
We prove
that time and time again.
He's a champion. He's a two-time champion looking to become a three-time champion here in 2007. We'll be back for the finish here at Homestead right after this.
Ron Hornaday brings the Camping World Chevrolet to pit road. There will be a green-white checker to finish off this race, but they wanted to put fresh tires on this. Hornaday said he thought he may be getting a flat and just a little splash of gas to guarantee that they'll be able to get that Camping World Chevrolet to the finish here. Just a couple of laps to go, and the championship is in the hands of Ron Hornaday.
Ray, I'm glad to know that Ron thought he might have a tire going down, because I was really hoping that they weren't going to come in, put tires on this thing, and try to go out there and win that race.
Watch these two roll up on each other right here, Phil.
Yeah, there's Mike Skinner. He knows that they gave it the great fight. What a terrific season Mike Skinner had. He knows that more than likely, Ron Hornaday is going to win this championship.
That's just a show of respect. And you don't really know what it's like to win a championship unless you have before. And Skinner was saying, dude, you deserve this one.
Hey, we got a green-white check here. Two laps to go for this win.
A race still to be determined. Kyle Busch in front of Johnny Benson, Rick Crawford, and that two of Kevin Harvick.
That's not the start Johnny Benson wanted, but maybe he can run wide open through one and two and catch Kyle Busch as they race down the back straightaway.
Crawford moves to the outside, tries to keep the momentum up on his number 14, Ford.
Johnny closes in a little bit, coming off turn number two. What does he have for him down here in three and four?
Through three and four. Here comes Johnny Benson moving to the inside. Willie Allen's going to spin. Will that bring out the caution? No caution yet. The white flag will fly side by side for the lead.
Johnny's got the advantage on the inside. See if he can beat him to the corner.
Johnny Benson looking strong on the bottom of the racetrack. Kyle Busch trying to keep the momentum up on the high side. As they come out of two, down the back stretch they go. Johnny Benson in front.
Johnny passes him. He clears him.
into three and four. Now Johnny Benson trying to run the bottom of the racetrack. Here comes Kyle Busch on the high side. He can't do it. He's into the wall. Johnny Benson coming to the start-finish line. He'll win the final race of the season.
Wow. I was so enthralled in the championship battle, I forgot about the green-white checkered, and Johnny Benson made a great green-white checkered.
And how about our champion? Coming across the start-finish line, he will finish seventh in this race, but number one in the points.
Yeah, what a terrific season for Ron Hornaday. Really, Mike Skinner again.
Good job, guys. Awesome, awesome, awesome.
That was JB congratulating his team. What a nice job he did driving and getting around that 51 truck. Ray, who have you caught up with down there?
Well, I'm with Rick Wren, and Hornaday's been on the radio saying all of his congratulations. Rick wanted to add to the...
Wayne Otten's talking right now.
Okay, we'll listen in.
Thank you, Wayne. Appreciate it. Thanks to all of NASCAR.
Wayne Otten is the series director for the Craftsman Truck Series. And Rick, I want you to look back. You've been doing this for an awful long time. Where does this stack up in your memories of all of racing?
Well, you know, they don't give these things away. And we've been trying for an awful long time. And I told Ron Hornaday earlier this year, I said, I know you got some of those rings and I don't have one. I think we need to work really hard to get one. And I don't know what else to say. This is what we do this for, and it's like a dream come true.
All the work has paid off. Congratulations, the winning crew chief. That is Rick Wren. He'll get to go down and celebrate another championship with Ron Hornaday.
Johnny Benson celebrating the race. Ron Hornaday beginning the long celebration. He will take the head table when they go to the awards banquet.
What a great season for Johnny Benson. Four wins this year. Going to finish third in the points.
Remember we talked at the beginning of the show how important it is to finish third in the points instead of sixth. We highlighted it on Speed before the race even started. And Johnny Benson maximized and drove up into that third spot in points.
Unofficially, it looks like Travis Quapel may have dropped three positions here in this race. All the way from third back down to sixth.
There's your top five. Johnny Benson, Kyle Busch, Rick Crawford, Kevin Harvick, and Jason Leffler here at the Ford 200 in Homestead, Florida.
All right, Horn. Great job, brother.
Way to go, guys. Ron Hornaday, champion of 2007.
Awesome job, guys. I have no idea what to say. Dark Horse, you guys are awesome. Unbelievable.
Third championship for Ron Hornaday. He celebrates with team owner Kevin Harvick, teammates on the racetrack today, celebrating today, and one who is not going to celebrate for quite some time, Mike Skinner is with Chris Devoto.
Yeah, and as you see right here, Mike Skinner saluting and waving to Kevin Harvick, the championship owner. Mike Skinner walking around to the truck. I joked with Mike Skinner as I walk up to him and I said, this is not the way I was planning on interviewing you. And he said, you know, it wasn't from a lack of performance. We were leading the race when it all fell apart. But he was good natured, good spirited, and a good champion regardless. Mike, you said if it wasn't going to be you, you could think of no better person to have it than Ron Hornaday. But what were your thoughts when all the trouble started and you found yourself back behind the wall?
We were leading the race. We were doing what we were supposed to do, and our Tundra was really good. Had a great motor. Had good motors all year. Great trucks all year. I guess the hub was coming apart. The brake pedal was going to the floor. It was vibrating really bad. We thought it was the right front to start with because it was so much vibration in the wheel. So they changed right side tires, and that didn't fix it. It just got worse and worse and worse and worse, and it finally came apart.
Any regrets on the season? Are you able to go to bed tonight and think, hey, we did everything we could?
Guys did a good job. I regret we didn't have a spare hub in the pits, but, you know, we took one off another housing, but it wasn't going to make, as it came down, it wasn't going to make any difference anyway. So it was a great year.
All right. That's Mike Skinner. A great year. Not the championship, but a good spirit nonetheless. Adam?
And while Skinner unable to clinch the title, it's a happy night for Bill Davis Racing because his teammate Johnny Benson in victory lane for the fourth time in 2007. And it happens in the season finale here at the Homestead Miami Speedway. What a finish, and let's start with that pass for the lead going around Kyle Busch. That was nice.
That was way nice. You know, it's always fun to race here at Homestead. It's always a great race, a fun place to be, and got to really thank Toyota Certified Used Vehicles and Exide Batteries being on it for this weekend, and Valvoline, Bosch, just everybody involved. I mean, just a lot of great, great people that made this possible. Trip Bruce, this is man here. I mean, he said the thing would be pretty good. It's actually a short track truck, is one we had at Martinsville, so it's a great evening. And you know, we wanted to come here, win the race, not have an effect on our championship points, even though last week I kind of did, but in the same token, I needed my points too. So hopefully we didn't. That was okay today on that, and just really got to thank Toyota and just everybody involved, Bill Davis, Gail Davis, all those guys up there, because they're the ones that makes it good. And who won the championship? I don't even know.
Hornaday won the title.
Hornaday won it, so congratulations to them and their guys and Kevin Harvick. You know, they've had a great year. Mike Skinner had a great year also. Jeff Hensley and all those guys, a great, great effort this year. And you know, both those teams are capable of winning a championship, and you knew one of them was going to come up on top. And I hated to see Mike's problems, because they've been nice for Bill Davis for sure.
Johnny Benson with a great 2007 as well, and it all ends in victory lane, guys.
Johnny Benson celebrating the race, and Ron Hornaday celebrating, well, the championship, using the help of the pace truck. Randy Kaiser stopping for Ron Hornaday. We've seen him do burnouts in crazy places. How about that one? Ford Championship weekend is going to kick off with the crowning of the 2007 NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series champion. The team has made their way onto the stage, and they're waiting for their driver to celebrate this championship. Let's go down to Ray Dunlap.
Well, and here he comes. Rick Wren is beside him. Ron Hornaday got his 33rd win this season, and now another championship in the NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series. He wanted to wave some water around or something. He goes to the crew. Truck Chief Danny Stockman getting a high five there, and he goes down the line to say hi to these guys. And Ron, I'll tell you, he's coming down here to say hi to everybody, but how about talking to Wally Rogers and rest of the group? Your thoughts, Ron, on another championship. This was an unbelievable battle that you and Mike had all throughout the season.
Ha ha, Jack Sprague, I tied with you now, and I got more wins, though. But I got to think, first of all.
And he'll be your teammate.
Wally right here started this whole deal at Kevin Harvick Incorporated, and he got moved to the Busch side. Rick Wren, everybody Camping World, RVs.com, Chevrolet, man, RCR. I got to thank them. Each week they're just getting better and better, helping us out, and these things just live. Now, knock on wood. Man, I don't see it. Hi, Pop. Love you. We did it. Hopefully I can get you down here. Just, darn, when I seen Mike do that, I was like, what do you do? You know, I didn't see a tire rubbing or anything, and hate to see it for Mike, but you know what? This is the only way one of us are going to win this thing, and what a great year. If I didn't win it, you know, I'd like to have seen Mike done it, but this whole Camping World Chevrolet has done it, and it's all due to Kevin and Delana Harvick and all these Camping World guys right here, every one of them. Hopefully they all made it down here, because this is awesome.
When you look back on this season, Ron, what would you say has been the highlight of the year?
Everything. Coming to the racetrack with a truck like we've got every weekend. And these guys done an awesome job with a Chevrolet truck. And I think the whole change was when Camping World come aboard. I won a lot of races in that blue and yellow, and it comes back right now. So it's pretty cool.
Jack Sprague comes over to give us a little shower. Congratulations.
Today?
We will have the official crowning here in just a little bit, so stand by.
Thank you.
All right, Ron Hornaday, the champion. Let's check back in with Chris Devoda.
Well, and Ray, actually, Jack Sprague, before he gave that shower to Ron Hornaday, came up and gave it to his owner, Kevin Harvick. Congratulations, a championship owner. Your thoughts as you were not only the owner but driver tonight watching your guy.
Well, I mean, everybody on this Camping World team, I mean, it's something that everybody works for. It's taken us, you know, 6 years to get the truck team to where it's at, and great driver in Ron Hornaday. So it's hard to race and race in that position and try to win the race, and that's what we tried to do there at the end. And I was a little tough on my truck, but the coolest part about this whole thing is just being able to stop and be the first one to congratulate Ron Hornaday on the back straightaway. And you know, he's done so much for my racing career, and be able to win a championship with him and a lot of the guys that grew up with me in my racing career is is something I'll never forget. So this is pretty special.
A big smile on Kevin Harvick's face, the winning owner for 2007 season, as he gets the handshake from NASCAR President Mike Helton. Rick?
And I can't imagine that smile is going to go away, because if you think about it, he now has two three-time series champions as his two drivers for next season. Ron Hornaday, Jack Sprague, teammates in 08, both with three championships under their belt.
The NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series on Speed is presented by the Ford F-150, built for tough. Brought to you in part by the official tools of NASCAR, Craftsman, and by Aaron Sales and Lease Ownership. Nobody beats Aaron's, nobody.
It's taken 25 races and thousands of miles to decide who the champion is, and now we're about to crown officially our champion, Ray Dunlap.
Well, he gets a hug from Dallana Harvick, and Ron, if you'll step in here right now, I'd like Mike Helton, who is the president of NASCAR, to give you a congratulations on another championship.
Ron, on behalf of all NASCAR, congratulations, buddy. You and Kevin and Dallana made it really exciting this year, and we're proud of you. We're looking forward to celebrating with you at the banquet coming up pretty quick, and couldn't tell you how proud we are having you back as our champion, and all you've done to build the truck series and make it exciting and a lot of fun to enjoy and to watch. Thank you.
Thank you, Mike. We appreciate that. You'll get a chance to talk here in just a moment, because I want Scott Howard to come in here. Scott is the manager of brand and sponsorship for Sears Craftsman, and you've got a nice little something you'd like to present, I'm sure.
I do, Ron. On behalf of all of the people that work at Craftsman, congratulations on your third NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series Championship. Great job.
And he's got the hat on right here, and now he gets the hardware. Rick ran up here celebrating right beside him, along with Kevin and Dallana. And Ron, you've got the official trophy right now, and it's in the record books. Congratulations.
I don't have a trophy like this one. I've got something that looks like it, but this is unbelievable. Kevin Dallana believing in a grandpa. And you know what? I made the history book.
How old are you?
49.
Been 49 since I've known him.
We showed some good video earlier on today, Ron, about all the years of you and Mike competing against each other, and that was part of the fun for me to look back on what a wild journey it's been since 1995.
Yeah, it's so hard to talk with this thing echoing back. You got the earplugs, but it comes down to great teams, and everybody standing up here has part of it, and it's so cool to be an opportunity to drive for Camping World Chevrolet, RCR with all the support, Dollar General, Road Loans, everybody supported this whole thing. You know, my champion speech is that was it, and I'm done, because I just got to thank everybody. Harvick can talk on this one.
All right. Kevin, anything you'd like to add?
I just want to say thank you to everybody. Thanks to Speed and this old guy for giving it hell every week.
All right. Part of the ownership. How about the other part? What do you think of the old guy? He did pretty good.
He can drive as long as he wants. He's got a job forever.
All right. I like the sound of that. He's got the official hat. You got a verbal agreement. You've got a trophy. Where's the champagne? We got champagne somewhere? Huh? Okay, we'll do that later. Whatever. Congratulations, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome Ron Hornaday, winning another NASCAR Craftsman Truck Series title.
The battle between two veterans, 50-year-old Mike Skinner, 49-year-old Ron Hornaday. Hornaday winning his third championship in 2007.
You know, Craftsman has a wide variety of different size toolbox for the do-it-yourselfer, a roll-away for your shop, but I want to show you the newest and greatest. This is the AXS series, and this thing is loaded with features. Now, on the bottom is a 7-drawer roll-away, on the top, a 6-drawer cart. Now, these two look great together, and this is in the stainless steel version, but you can get it in a multitude of different colors. But it's loaded with features. There's a power strip here on the side to plug in all your chargers, a place to plug in your cell phone, and all of these things are great, but check this out. An LED light underneath the bottom of this top shelf
shines down on all of your drawers, so when you open them up, you can see your tools, and they're all full of ball bearings. Now, this is a really neat feature right here. It allows you to tell the temperature inside and outside of your shop. It tells you the time of day, and there's a timer on here, so you can set it, and it'll tell you it's time to go to lunch. With the season just about over, remember, the holidays are just around the corner, and with this new toolbox, you'll even know where it is when you shut out the lights.
Take a look at our unofficial results for the Ford 200. Johnny Benson in his 100th start, finding his 9th career win.
We saw Jason Leffler get the Aaron's Lucky Dog, winds up in the top five. Good run for him.
Good run for Tim Sauter, finishes in 11th spot. Justin Marks with a great run, his best career finish in the top 10 and 8th.
Willie Allen finishing in the 28th spot. He is your Rookie of the Year, even though involved in that accident at the end of the race.
Jacques Villeneuve, great run early on, ends up the only truck not running at the finish.
And Mike Skinner says, darn it, I needed some attrition tonight to get this championship.
Take a look at the final point standings for this 2007 season. Ron Hornaday with luck at the end, Mike Skinner with bad luck.
Let's look at the last four races. Those two guys raced each other heads up at Martinsville in Texas, and both of them overachieved. Then we go to Phoenix, and we come here. Problems dictated who won the championship tonight.
And the celebration will continue for Ron Hornaday. Again, the banquet that celebrates Ron Hornaday's championship will be December 7th, right here on Speed. 9 p.m. the start for that. It all began back in Daytona. We kicked the season off. Two top 10 finishes for our championship contenders in that first race. And from that point forward, they battled back and forth to determine who would be our champion in the 2007 season. Want to thank everyone involved in the show that takes place. Our senior management, Hunter Nickel, Rick Miner, Steve Craddock, and Frank Wilson, our coordinating producer, David Lee, our producer, Keith D'Alessandro, Roger Vinson, our director, Mark Cole, our technical producer, Jason Avery, our pit producer, Michael Flanagan, our tape producer, and our feature producers, Joel Manick, Brian Goodwin, Jamie Nakrasin, and the others on TV with us, Chris DeVoto.